Welcome back. Dang it, welcome back.
Christian? You are in the shot.
Whoa, why?
Welcome back. This is Talks with Taylor. I'm Taylor Loki, and today we have Ryan Burks. All right, what book or movie left a lasting impression on you?
Book? Probably Hank the Cow Dog. You ever read that one?
I have not.
I don't know if I have either, but I checked it out at the book fair one time, like kindergarten, and I just remember it sat on my bookshelf for a while. And
left an impression on
you. Yeah. I'm not a big reader. I don't read much.
Okay. What's one object that you hope is obsolete in 20 years?
Probably social media, which is ironic because this is going on social media. But I do feel like I spend a lot of time on social media. I think a lot of people do. And it would just be cool to live in a world where we don't have it.
What is something that you did as a child that now makes you cringe?
Oh, this is a true story. In seventh grade, I think it was sixth or seventh grade, because I was at Strickland. It was the last day of school, and we were signing yearbooks in front of the school on the lawn.
Mm-hmm.
And I think I had a crush on this girl. I'm not going to say who it was, because she definitely still lives in Denton. But I saw her, like, eagle-eyed her from probably 200 yards away, and she hadn't signed my yearbook. So I sprinted across the lawn in front of, I don't know, the whole school. There's probably, in my mind, there was probably 400 people out there. There might have been 200. I tripped in the sprinkler hole, like in the ground. There was, the cap was missing. Foot went completely in it, like head over heels in front of everybody. And I think I just got up and went straight home. It was the most embarrassing thing that's ever happened to me.
Just chalked it up to a fail, huh?
My yearbook has one blank space in it where her name should be.
If money was not an issue, what's one odd job that you could see yourself doing?
I want to be like a rescue scuba diver.
So you're rescuing scuba divers?
That's the beauty of being a rescue scuba diver. I might need to go rescue another scuba diver. Could be looking for like a submarine or anything like that.
Yeah. Who is one fictional character that you identify with and why?
Probably Napoleon Dynamite. Because when I was a kid, I had an afro. About the same time the yearbook stick went down. Yeah, I looked just like Napoleon Dynamite.
I gotta see the fro, man. I think could you grow it back out for us? Do you still get that same bounce?
Oh, yeah.
Really?
Oh, yeah. This time of year with the humidity, dude, things looking right.
If you had to choose one color to embody your personality, what color would it be?
Beige. It's just kind of run of the mill, probably. But I could see it being blue, too. Like, I try to be pretty relaxed and calm. Keep the blood pressure down, you know?
What does fulfillment mean to you?
Fulfillment is when I feel like I'm using my gifts the way I'm supposed to be using them.
I can see that.
You wake up, you feel like you're making a difference, you have purpose, and you go to bed happy.
All right, this is a two-part question.
Okay.
Do you have a hidden talent? And B, can you do it right now?
Yeah, I do. Do you want me to do it right now?
I do.
Okay. Can you do that?
What was that?
Can't tell you.
Pick one. Someone misquoting movies or television shows, or somebody mistakenly singing the wrong lyrics.
Yeah, singing the wrong lyrics for sure. I think it's hilarious.
All right. Guacamole or queso?
If it's good, like high quality, guacamole.
Oh, yeah. Shopping online or in stores?
In stores. Easy.
Really?
Yeah.
I would not have guessed that.
Why?
I don't know. You seem pretty Gen Z-ish. I just figured Amazon comes to your house 5 or 6 times a day.
No. It goes back to the social media thing. I want to be out there seeing people, hanging out.
Would you rather be followed by a band everywhere you go or by someone narrating your life?
The band. Easy.
Okay.
They're taking requests. Band all day.
All right. Good take.
Next up, Christian Schofield.